Scrooge McDuck. Merry Christmas, Justin. Merry Christmas to you, my friend. Kel Kimball 100. How to control your emotions? Asks over on Twitch. Just takes experience, but it just takes mindfulness, right? You have to make a commitment to not make irrational choices based on emotion, okay? So here are some simple practical ways to help control your emotions in trading. These are things that I teach my students. Rule number one, when you wake up in the morning, the first thing that you need to do is absolutely nothing. Do not look at your phone. Do not look at the charts. Do not talk to anyone. When you first wake up in the morning, get up, make your bed, sit back down on your bed, close your eyes, put your hands on your knees, and just focus in on you for 5 to 15 minutes. Concentrate on being aware of your surroundings, being aware of who you are, taking deep breaths, and thinking about exactly how your day is going to go. Tell yourself what you're going to do, not what you want to do, what you're going to do. Establish that sense of control over your own destiny in your mind in the morning and make a commitment to be aware of your fears, of your anxieties, to be aware of your surroundings, to speak correctly, to think before speaking, to speak with wisdom, to speak with courage, and to be courageous and brave. That's what I do every single morning, and it's a huge contributing factor in why I largely feel positive most of the time. There's always downsides. I go through stress. I go through unhappiness. I go through sadness. I've gone through periods of despair. I've had quite an interesting life. Seen all kinds of sides of the emotional roller coaster, guys. I trade crypto. But I think that's absolutely essential. You need to start off the day feeling powerful and strong, because you are powerful and strong if you just remember that. You just remember that. So you have to remind yourself. You remind yourself by being aware who you are and your surroundings. Number two, more specific to trading. Never ever buy on a big green candle. Never ever sell on a big red candle. Now, as you become experienced in the market, you can begin to do that if it fits in your strategy and you start to understand what a real breakout or breakdown look like. But in the beginning, and again, let me be very clear about this, for your first 2 years, everybody's learning curve is a little different, but 2 years, I'm just going to say that as just a generalized point in time. For the first 2 years of your trading career, don't do that. It's a big green candle and you feel FOMO. You're like, oh man, this is going to go up. I need to get in on this trade. Nope, you're not allowed to do that. You are not allowed to do that. Write that down on a piece of paper that you will never do that. Understand what it means when you write that. Then put that on the desk where you trade. Similarly for selling or shorting on a big red candle. Just don't ever do that. If you do not allow yourself to do that and you review that every time that you sit down to trade, then you won't make that mistake. Because that is how you sell the bottom and buy the top. And you don't want to do that. If you can just eliminate those options, you've eliminated some of the majority of retail traders' biggest losses and biggest mistakes, right? So never do that. Number three is always trade with a plan. Never, ever, ever just open up a chart, look at it for a little bit, and then to take a trade just because it feels right. Never do that. That is your first step in the journey toward becoming a consistently profitable trader. I have met a handful of people who can do that, who can just pull open the chart, and I've traded for a long time. I've talked to all kinds of traders. There are a few people out there, and I mean a few, who can just look at the chart, look at naked price action, and just get it right, right? They just get it right. There are a few people who can do that. I'm sure there are going to be some people who say that it's a skill that you can learn, blah, 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 blah. Like, I don't really think so. I think some people are born with some like magical intuitive ability to just follow price along and be more right than not. But for myself and for the majority of everybody out there, you need a strategy that is defined to have success in the market, right? You need to control your emotions. You need to write out your position sizing strategy. You need to write out your risk management strategy. You need to write out your entry strategy. You need to write out your exit strategy. You need to test and have a plan for all of these things. And for every single trade that you ever put on for the rest of your life, you need to know a few things. When are you going to enter and what needs to happen for you to enter, specifically, as specific as possible? Not, well, if price goes up here and gets rejected, then I'll enter. That's too vague. I need to see a candle close above or below a price level. I need to see a candle open and close above or below a price level. I need to see a candle's wick touch or come within 0.5% of this moving average and then close below. Very specific. Or I need this indicator to close with this signal. Those are typically what we're more going to talk about here. We're indicator guys generally around here. You need to know when you're going to enter and why you're going to enter. You need to know when you're going to take profit and take profit there no matter what, right? This is a problem. People get into a trade. They happen to get a good entry. Price starts moving in their favor. They have a take profit and they just get this magical feeling that price should just keep on going and they pull the take profit. They're like, well, I can make way more money on this. Let me just set this take profit lower or higher. Don't do that. That's a fool thing. That's a foolish thing. Only fools do that. Professional traders, serious traders, take profit when they said they were going to take profit. No exceptions every single time, period. You know, the market's not going anywhere, guys. It's not the last movement. There's going to be 1,000 more, right? Take profit when you said you'd take profit. Always pull cash off the table. And the last thing you need to know is when you're going to exit the trade and exactly why you're going to exit the trade when your trade setup has been invalidated and it's a loss. Pull your loser early and pull it every single time and reduce the option of massive losses affecting your account balance. And pro tip, when you're beginning trading, first 2 years or so, first 6 months, whatever, if you exit a trade at a loss, immediately close the chart and don't look at it for 48 hours. Preferably a week. Just go to another trade. The worst thing you can do to yourself is hindsight thinking, well, if I just would have stayed in the trade or added risk, it would have been a winner. Don't think that way. Losers think that way. You're not a loser. You're a winner. Don't do that to yourself. Just some thoughts. And most importantly, as Ricky Thompson said over here, it is his trading systems that allow him to control his emotions. Absolutely correct. So what I just said, have a trading strategy, and this becomes very easy. Emotional discipline is bolstered and strengthened by having a trading strategy, and vice versa. Take the time to develop a strategy and stop clicking random buttons. You'll do okay.